Welcome everyone to the Fire Nation. Let's give some caramel chocolate to Fire Nation here. How was this colony named Fire Nation? Well, it's thanks to you guys who voted in a previous iPoll set up in one of my past videos. And so, Fire Nation it is. Now these red tropical fire ants of Fire Nation love sweets. Actually, this is the very first time these ants have ever had a taste of chocolate. Look at how excited they are. The ants immediately identify that a large tasty treat has fallen from the skies. And the message spreads fast throughout the entire colony. Excited sisters come rushing out of the entrances of the nearby nest to have a taste of this delicious treat that awaits them. Now these ants don't have vocal cords, so the only way they communicate is through pheromones. And right now, you better believe that the food pheromone is all over the place. Some sisters rush to nearby satellite nests to deliver the news. These ants have no idea what this food is, but they do know that it tastes great. Now you want to hear something really cool? Ants have two stomachs. They have their own stomach, and they have a social stomach. Now when they eat food on location like this, they fill up their social stomach, which is kind of like a personal lunchbox. And then, through a process called trophallaxis, they transfer this food mouth to mouth, which means the bulk of the colony can remain inside the nest, and they don't have to venture out into the world outside where there can be many dangers. Most of the colony remains inside the nest, waiting for members who have ventured outside of the nest to eat the food, return to the nest, and bring back the food stored in their social stomachs, and thereby get a taste of the food that's just outside. This means that not a single member of the colony goes hungry, and that includes all of the young. Isn't that amazing? These ants have mastered food distribution. And you want to hear something else that's amazing? In the ant world, only the oldest ants are the ones that leave the nest. The senior citizens are the ones that venture out into the world outside, subjecting themselves to dangers along the way. And it's their responsibility to bring back food to the nest. Fire Nation here will be a very happy colony, because in just a few hours, each one of these ants and the young will have had a taste of our delicious caramel chocolate. And so our ants of Fire Nation can rest assured that they'll be able to survive another week. And all thanks to our giant delectable gift that fell from the heavens. Meanwhile, in a colony nearby, black crazy ants don't have it as easy. They need to solve this maze in order to get to this little drop of corn syrup. Watch them go, guys! Well, that didn't take very long. Now watch as this ant that's filled its social stomach heads back to the nest. And on its way back, it leaves a pheromone trail, indicating that at the end of this pheromone trail lies a tasty treat. Look at all these crazy ants heading to the drop now. You'll notice that they don't even check out the other areas of the maze. They know exactly where the food is. It isn't long before word spreads to the entire colony back at the nest that there's a drop of sweets just a little bit outside of the nest. Isn't that cool, guys? Look at them filling up their social stomachs. Now, some of you guys might be asking, all right, well, what about ants in the wild that might not be anywhere near human settlement? Where do they get their sweets? Well, on a recent trip to the Pacific island known as Guam, I was able to film some ants that get their sugars from ant cows.
Oh my god, look what I just found. Solenopsis farming some aphids. Okay, I'm gonna try to do this carefully because they're probably going to try to defend their ant cows from my finger. But look, they're totally farming some aphids there. That is so great. They're ant cows. For those of you who aren't aware, many species of ants tend ant cows, which are either aphids or some other kind of plant insects. And these plant insects produce honeydew, which is a sweet secretion that they excrete. And the ants eat it. It's sweet. It's food to the ants. So it's kind of like how humans have cows and we milk cows for milk. These ants milk these aphids for honeydew. It's a great symbiotic relationship because the ants defend and care for the aphids. Really neat.
Another place ants can get their sugars is from nectar from flowers. And in the process, ants pollinate the flowers.
All right, we got ginger, I believe. And I see some ants in there. If you look in there, as well as some other insects buzzing about. I believe that's Nylandaria. Yeah, Nylandaria pollinating this ginger plant.
Tutorial time! Alright guys, so why do ants love sweets so much? Well, they actually need it. Not only do ants need protein, which they get from insects, or decaying meats, but ants also need carbohydrates in the form of sugars, like this chocolate. However, most ants will consume sugars in the form of sugar water, honey water, or hummingbird nectar. You can offer this in a test tube setup or in a simple feeder by placing it in a container and poking pinholes. You can also try offering fresh fruit. Ant colonies need sugars because it offers the colony ATP, which is energy. Workers work really hard around the clock, and so they need this energy the most. Sugary foods also offer the colony a broad array of vital nutrients. So try to offer your ants different kinds of sugars, and I promise you, your ant colony will flourish. A lot of times, people often write to us saying how their colony isn't doing so well, and everything seems to be right, except that they don't offer enough sugars, and usually it's enough to solve the problem. Sugars and carbohydrates are just as important as protein in an ant diet, so please be sure to offer your ants something sweet to get them going. Thanks so much for watching our video. Take care. See you next week. It's Ant Love Forever. Now, I don't know what is going on here, but it is crazy. Thank you so much to all of our new subscribers who watched our last video and who are starting to watch all the videos on this channel. I cannot believe how many people out there have ant love. I absolutely love you guys. Thank you so much for joining the AntsCanada family, for subscribing to us, and for watching our videos. We've got a lot of great ant videos coming up. I find ants are the most amazing creatures on this planet, and I look forward to you guys discovering just how amazing they are. They bring insights to ourselves and to the world around us. It's Ant Love Forever, guys. See you next week. And don't forget to hit that bell icon. Thanks.